I'm going to call this my dog Maya. And this is Billy. About a week or so ago, I took her out between 9 and like 9:15, 9:30. Go to the bathroom. So she was acting like she had to go. Took her out in the green one, knowing that part half of it. Right there. Over there. This way it's from Danny's. Not being used attached to the collar. And before I even took her out, I thought, let's put on a red one, because my mom got her a 20-foot red leash so that she had something to run on it to worry about with the arc, for instance. But instead, I took her out on a green one. It was a Saturday night, I remember it, because it was right after new episode of Last Chance Highway and before a new episode of Pit Boss. And take her out, and I realized there's a rabbit out there, and that's why she wanted out. So she gets pulling, and then she sits, and she stares at the rabbit for a few seconds, and she takes off, and snaps the green leash in half. Well, maybe not necessarily in half, because it's not in half. But she broke it. And this is what is left of it. That's most of it. That's the small part of it. She broke a 5 or 6 foot leash because she wanted to choose a rabbit. So, oh, and by the way, she's like 25% beagle, so that probably explains a lot. And I go back inside and grab her red leash and the red collar. And I'm on her all the way out for 10, 20 minutes trying to find out where she is. And then on my way back, I'm trying to find her. She comes running over into our yard and then out to the street, and I'm like flipping because we live on like close enough to the street where she could have run out into the street, and she didn't, thank God. And she goes charging over towards our neighbor's yard because there's a couple people over who live over there that she really, really likes. The names are Carolyn and Larry. The last names aren't important to you in the web world. And but before she actually gets over there, I was able to get her over to me to grab the back of her neck like this. I was able to hang on to her long enough to put the collar on her. And you'd think I'd be used to it, but before I actually moved here, in the process of moving here, she'd gotten out of the backyard from where we lived before, which was 325 South 2nd Street. Don't ever move there if you can. It's a piece of crap house. She'd gotten out, took off, she had her collar on that time, with her license, her doggy license, and her vaccination tag, and she was probably gone, probably about the same amount of time, maybe longer. And I'm freaking out then, because that's the first time that ever happened. And I actually started crying, because I didn't think I'd get a vet. But the person that helped me do the papers with told me not to worry, because she's got beagle in her. She'll always come back, because she's got enough beagle in her where she can smell her way back to where we live, thankfully. And she did. Thank you. story of how when I got out, broke a leash, and just a rabbit. Her name is Maya, M-Y-A. Her breed is 50% Pitbull from her father, 25% Dalmatian, and 25% Beagle from her mother. Just so you know.